Read BBS, BBS, Black Burt Sugar, Bachelor's in Boxing Studies, Television, Fred Sanford of the Fistic Arts, John Bones Jones, UFC Light Heavyweight Champion. Damn. John Bones Jones, UFC Light Heavyweight Champion and certified fuck up. As great as Jones is at fucking people up, best mixed martial artist I've ever seen, clearly John Jones is better at fucking up in life. Obviously, you've heard he was arrested early a.m. Thursday morning for aggravated DWI, negligent use of firearms, possession of an open container, and no proof of insurance. Now, before we swan dive all up into that, need to encourage you to subscribe. Here's the deal. My subscribers are coronavirus free. So go ahead and touch that subscribe button. If you have the coronavirus, you'll be cured. If you don't have the coronavirus, subscribe and you'll be immune to it immediately. Trust me. Join us. Comment. You comment, I comment. You comment, I comment. That's how this works. Sharing is caring. Love tap and or bitch slap that like button for you, boy. But getting back to this one, man. Jones, a self-professed look-see-do fighter. No, John Jones is a look-see-fuck-up human being. Look-see-fuck-up human being. We're a second-chance society. But Jones, he's been given 3 or 4 second chances now. Hell or more, I done lost count. The mishaps are officially overshadowing Jones's talent, accomplishments, and wins. Literally. He's more known for fuck-uppery than who he actually beat. And that's sad, man. That's sad. My man Jones, he's an infinity degree black belt in fuck-up jitsu. Yes, an infinity degree black belt in fuck-up jitsu. He grabbed a pebble from the hand of the blind fuck-up master a long time ago. The blind dude. Yeah, the blind fuck-up master. Jones grabbed that pebble out of his hand a long time ago. The Bruce Lee of fucking up? No. The Bruce Leroy of fucking up? Chuck Norris, sure enough. The Von Damme of fucking up? Jim Kelly? Oh, no. Oh, no. John Jones is the fuck-up master. Make no mistake. Ariel Helwani, he called Jones the Daryl Strawberry, the Dwight Doc Gooden of MMA. And that's true. It's true. Two immensely talented baseball players whose potential was undermined by addiction and vices. Now, my tone is obviously harsh, but for real, like, I'm coming from a good place. I'm a John Jones fan, and I don't think he's a bad person. I really don't. I'm not wagging my finger at him either. I'm not pretending to be above his struggles. We all have vices, some more than others. Thing is, Jones says all the right shit all the fucking time, yet continues to make piss poor decisions. Piss poor. It's like this, man. I'm gonna be blunt. If you know you're gonna get drunk and or high, rent a goddamn limo. Call Uber. It's not like you can't afford it. It's not like you can't afford it, but okay, if you insist on driving, if it's a control issue with you, at least wait until you get to your destination, then light it up. Get shit-faced. I don't give a fuck, but stay there until you've sobered up, unless you have a designated driver. Most importantly, if you're gonna get drunk, you're gonna have marijuana residue on your person, and you're behind the wheel of a car, at least don't bust a fucking shot in the air with your goddamn firearm. That's the dumbest part of all this. You got liquor in the car, open bottle of liquor, you're drunk, marijuana residue, you have a firearm in the car, and then you just decide to bust it off. Come on, bruh. That's the dumbest part of all this, John. Come on, bruh. The only positive, the only silver lining, is John Jones was drinking a bottle of Recuerdo Mezcal, the homie Jorge Masvidal's brand. That's the only saving grace here. But to paraphrase Daniel Cormier, John Jones, get your shit together. Read BBS, BBS, Black Burt Sugar, Bachelor's in Boxing Studies, Television, Fred Sanford of the Fistic Arts. When all is said and done, there's nothing left to say or do.